At the invitation of his colleague, President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, Felix Tshisekedi of the Democratic Republic of Congo, DRC, yesterday paid a working visit to Uganda. Tshisekedi was accompanied by his ministers and other senior government officials, was received at State House Entebbe by President Museveni. During the bilateral talks, the heads of state discussed matters of mutual interest, reviewed the current situation and developments in the region, and reaffirmed their commitment to regional peace and security.
For the good discussions we have held today,
des discussions très enrichissantes et très prometteuses,
very useful discussions that promise a lot,
qui ont tourné essentiellement autour du processus de paix, cette paix que nous voulons pour
which
notre
turn
région.
Around the issue of peace which we all like to have.
The bilateral security issues between Uganda and DRC.
Premièrement, la question de la sécurité bilatérale entre l'Ouganda et le RDC.
Secondly,
deuxièmement,
security of the region.
La sécurité de la région.
Thirdly,
troisièmement,
the issue of petroleum in Lake Albert.
La question du pétrole dans le lac Albert.
And then four,
quatrièmement,
the infrastructure.
The two heads of state also emphasized the importance of strengthening the existing economic and commercial ties between Uganda and DRC, recognizing the pivotal role these relationships play in fostering growth and stability in the two countries and the wider East African region. Kampala Metropolitan Police yesterday conducted an operation in the city where they impounded several bodas, arresting some of the operators for not having driving permits. Among the hotspots where the operations were conducted was Wandegeya, Church House and Clock Tower. While taking advantage of the traffic jam in the city, the police field force unit were seen working jointly with the traffic police to impound the non-compliant bodas, impounding them and loading them onto breakdown trucks. A census on motorcycles by KCCA conducted in 2022 revealed that out of the 42,000 motorcycles registered, 37,000, standing for 88%, were boda riders. 94% of these boda riders did not have driving licenses, 98% did not have passenger service vehicle PSV licenses, and only 157 riders had all the requirements to operate. Kamala Harris supporters waited for her arrival at rally in Raleigh, North Carolina, one of the seven battleground states that could determine who wins the closest, oddest, and most consequential election in modern U.S. history. Harris traveled to North Carolina and then to Pennsylvania, focusing again on what could determine who wins the closest. For weeks, the race has been locked in a statistical dead heat. North Carolina has never voted for a Democratic president since it went with Barack Obama in 2008, and in a sign of how hotly contested it is, Trump was in the same town yesterday, in the town of Rocky Mount, about an hour's drive from Harris's rally.
It was amazing, especially just to see that name on the ballot. And we were there when she was there. We were on campus at the same time. I didn't know her, of course, but we were on campus at the same time. So it's a great feeling.
Yeah, it's fantastic. It's the Howard University pride going to the next level. Gotta love it. The enthusiasm is awesome.
Trump had the second rally planned in yet another swing state, Wisconsin, in the Midwest, where he appeared with Brett Favre, an American football legend. As Trump struggled to deal with the fallout from a self-inflicted wound over the weekend that infuriated Latino voters, a key demographic, Harris gave a powerful closing argument speech in a highly symbolic setting.